I'm not one that goes to a doctor. So I just, you know, bluffed it off with nothing. But I couldn't eat. It just wouldn't go down. It just came back up. I'm very social, as you can probably tell. I do go out a lot. And a lot of it has to do with food. It was sort of embarrassing. I had to sit by the door where you could run to the restroom because I didn't have any confidence in what was going to happen.
And it just got to the point finally where she just couldn't swallow at all. I was very worried. I thought I was going to lose her for sure.
When it got to the point when I couldn't even swallow water, it was really scary. That's when I thought, well, I better go to the doctor. They gave me some kind of medication for that, but that didn't work. They weren't sure what it was, and they were trying to find out, I guess, before they sent me to Stanford.
And then like a month would go by, and we'd see the doctor again and say, listen, she's losing a pound a day. We got to do something about this. I mean, I actually had to get a massive. It has to be done. You do something. Find somebody, you know, and that's when they call Dr. Rivas.
Esophageal achalasia is a failure to relax of the lower portion of the esophagus. So their nerve cells in that area, the ones to relax, they're gone. And we don't really know why.
He was a wonderful doctor. It was such a relief to go to a doctor that isn't in a hurry to get to the next patient because he really was very complete as far as telling me what was going to happen.
The treatment of choice for this would be to do what we call a myotomy. Myotomy, that means to cut a muscle. In this case, circular fibers that are around that esophagus in the lower area.
I researched him and found out, oh my God, this guy's less invasive.
There were only 7 doctors in the United States that did this type of surgery.
We make a small, less than an inch incision in the lining of the esophagus to then travel all the way down to that area of trouble, where we have those multiple circular fibers, and we simply can just cut them, release that pressure, and give a new quality of life to people like Ms. McFadden.
I remember waking up in the room where they returned me. They brought me some soup, and when I swallowed that, I was very cautious, so I just took a sip, and it was such a pleasure to be able to swallow and keep it down. My life is back, thank goodness. Everything just tastes so good. I'm so happy to be able to eat. It seemed like it was so long without food. I mean, being able to swallow it and enjoy it. I've been very fortunate, very, very fortunate. Not everybody gets a second chance. I might end up eating the whole thing.